Abdul, Executive Chairman, DSLSA, members of the DSLSA, Mr. Ashok Kumar, Secretary Education, Mr. Amit Yadav, Chairman NDMC, all ladies and gentlemen, and all the young children, though I don't know, they have performed so well. Such a mesmerizing performance they have given. Where they have gone, but I don't know. Are they there still? Yes, they're there. Some of them are. Good. You really enchanted us. Both the performances over. It's my real pleasure to be here, to be given this opportunity, though I'm not a part of this committee, but still given an opportunity to be here at this event when you're celebrating the first milestone of such an initiative which is going to help not only the children otherwise, but the JDC, it will help our committee, the JDC, in achieving its goals. Legal literacy, as always, I've always felt, is a pivotal point for having an informed society. As a member of the profession, during my years in the bar and the bench, I've always seen a lot of people who don't even know their basic rights and remedies. That is where, and they don't know what to do. That is why they keep entangled in legal complications, where even when it's an interpretation of a contract, they don't understand, because nobody has given them that. They don't understand, like, especially nowadays we see cyber crimes, people don't understand because they don't know the law. POXO, people don't know they have to complain. So this is where legal literacy plays a very, very important role. The concept of legal literacy for children is even more important, because ultimately the children are very, very innocent people who don't know. They will get lost unless they are given this knowledge of law. And that is where this program Arushi, which the DLSA has launched, is going to go a long way. As I always say, the Juvenile Justice Act has made provisions that for children we must have friendly mechanism, so that even if they make mistakes, they don't have to be punished, they have to be reformed. So for children, this kind of an initiative will go a long, long way. What I want to say is that because the Juvenile Justice Committee has been doing a lot of work, I have seen as a chairman that a lot of juveniles are entangled in legal problems without knowing what their rights are. They don't know what the remedies they have. So they get lost. And that is where this initiative by the DLSA, where they have now reached schools. The Directorate of Education must be commended for this, for doing this and for taking this initiative to go and train these counselors. The counselors they have a very, very great connect with the children who may not even at home. I don't know how many children there are. They will say, well, there may be things which they don't tell their parents, but they must be discussing with the counselors. So counselors actually play a role. They can guide the children much more than maybe at times parents also. Though it's the duty of parents also, of course, the teachers, the system, the entire system has to do it. But if our counselors, these specialized counselors in the government schools, are doing such a fantastic job. And I saw the film there where we were saying that we have been interacting and we get to know things which the children don't disclose to others. This, the DSLSA was quick to notice that these counselors were doing their duty, but without knowledge of law, without knowledge of the basic procedures, they were not able to come with a solution for children who had legal problems. So now, with this basic training, they are going to go a long way. And I hope now this program, which is one of the most innovative programs, I must congratulate Mr. Gupta, the Member Secretary of the DSLSA, who under the able guidance of Honorable the Chief Justice and Justice Mridul, has taken this initiative and thought of this program. And in such a short span, so many EVGCs have been trained. I hope that this program goes further, and even private schools. I have been saying this in my meetings in the state level consultation in the Juvenile Justice Committee, that it's not only children in government schools who need help. We have to realize that even in public schools, children need this kind of help. And if I hope, Mr. Gupta, I hope you will take this program, extend this program with the help of the Directorate of Education to public schools also, and train people there who are dealing with children. With that, I will congratulate the DSLSA for this initiative and wish them all the best for it.